top those two hands to heaven and give him thanks for answered prayers, all the prayers prayed all through the week till this moment. Give him thanks. Now, thank you, Jesus. Blessed be your name. Give him glory and praise. Celebrate him. Lift up your two hands and celebrate him. If you believe that God heard you this morning, give him thanks. Would you say that in words, please? Say that in words. Not muttering words, but speaking words. Words of life. Lord Jesus, thank you for answers to all of our prayers since the week began. And thank you for hearing me in particular. If you prayed any prayer and you believe that God heard you, now give him thanks. Give him thanks in return. 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 There is no one like Jesus. Celebrate him. In Jesus' precious name we have prayed. One of the mysteries back of multiplication is thanksgiving. Out of them shall proceed thanksgiving and the voice of them that make merry, and I will multiply them, and they shall not be few. Almighty God, all-powerful God, you are worthy of our praise. Hallelujah. You believe God heard us? You believe we are going to see amazing multiplication tomorrow? Unprecedented gathering of multitudes? You believe that? So let's sing and praise him in that song. Almighty God, all-powerful God.
Almighty God, all-powerful God. Almighty God, all-powerful God. You are worthy to receive all the praise. You reign forevermore. Almighty God, all-powerful God. You.
thank you in the name of Jesus. You are behind the growth of this church. You are behind the happiness in this church. And will return all the glory to you. You are behind the revelations that we receive in this church. You are behind the signs and wonders that we experience. Receive our thanks in the name of Jesus. No one can come except you draw him, Father. We see them because you draw them. Receive our thanks in the name of Jesus. No one can multiply the congregation but you. We see the congregation multiply because your hand is behind it. Receive our thanks in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name. Give the Lord a big hand of praise, and please, you may be seated. God does not reward efforts made. He rewards results obtained. And that we've been looking at in all of our churches worldwide since that we began. God rewards reapers, not participants. He that reapeth receiveth wages. John 4:36. Not he that engages. Engagement must result in reaping and gathers fruits unto life eternal. The reaping must conclude with ingathering to secure the harvest. God does not reward efforts made. He rewards results obtained. We receive wages by reaping and in gathering of the harvest. But, and they that turn men to righteousness, as these stars, we are made stars, as we turn many to righteousness. We are paid for reaping the harvest. We are made for turning many to righteousness. And when God makes a man, no devil cannot make him. The anger of the wicked against a man made by God will always fall on their own head. For I will be an enemy to your enemy and an adversary to your adversary. I will bless them that bless thee, and him that curses you, I will curse. When God blesses, when God makes a man, when God makes a woman, when God makes a boy, he makes a girl, every assault against him or her boomerangs. We are paid by reaping the harvest. We are made by turning many to righteousness. And like we always say, it's better to be made than to be paid. What you are paid will be spent. What you are made is a lifelong asset. Stays with you. Lives with you. Daniel 12:3. And they that be wise shall shine as the brethren of the firmament, and they that turn many to righteousness as these stars forever and ever. So we should keep targeting his benchmark of many for us as individuals. His benchmark of many for each one is important. For unto whom much is given, much is required. Unto whom much is given, much is required. You can't hit many and not be made. Whenever anyone hits God's benchmark of many for him is made a star forever and ever. That means you can bring down that star. That means the devil and his agents can't tamper with that star. Thank you, Jesus. Remember, God does not honor groups. He honors individuals. So it's not enough to be present. It's important to be productively present, to be fruitfully present. It's not enough to be part of a prayer force. It's important for your voice as an individual to be heard in heaven. You can be there and slip away for 90% of the time and say nothing. And when they ask you, you don't even know what you said, because you said nothing. Shall we stand up? Yes, stand. Shall we pray? Okay, carry on. I'll be listening. It's important for your voice and my voice to be heard in heaven. Because God does not honor groups, he honors individuals. He that serves me, him will my Father honor. Not them will my Father honor. John 12, verse 26. If any man, not if any group, serve me, let him follow me. Where I am, there shall also my servant be. If any man serve me, him will my Father honor. One of our greatest problems in the charismatic is getting lost in the crowd. You're shouting, yeah. Nothing is turning because there is no personal stake in the things we do. There is no personal stake in the things we do. Like we say in the course of the week, no one wins the prize in any race without his personal dedication. This one thing I do, forgetting those things that are behind and reaching out forth to those that are before, I press towards the mark for the prize. I press towards the mark for the prize. It's important for us to engage personally, because God does not bless groups. He blesses individuals. He does not promote groups. He setteth up one and bringeth down another. Psalm 75, verse 5 and 6. Please don't be lost in the crowd. Don't be lost in the crowd. Don't be lost in the crowd. We have just one day, and then the deal day, tomorrow comes. Anybody can make anything happen today if he chooses to. By putting the best of your best and going beyond your best to ensure that you are not just a reaper, you are also an ingatherer, and your target is hitting God's benchmark of many for your life. And when that happens, your story changes forever. Your life comes on automatic. You are heavily defended. You are heavily guarded. Praise God. Does Job serve you for not? Have you not built an edge around him, around his house, and around all that he has on every side? And you are blessed. A star forever. Yes, it was challenging, but bounce back. Bounce back. He won't let go of God. He bounced back. The glory not only retained, doubled. Praise God. Please make your haste while the sun still shines. By this time tomorrow, the curtain is drawn on operation must go, must pray, go, bring and nurture. But you can make anything happen today by your personal, selfless, tireless engagement. Don't ever think you are serving a man. If you are, you'll be very frustrated. Understand that you are serving Christ. Understand that you are serving Christ. Understand that you are serving Christ. Long before I became a pastor, I was in it with all my being, with everything inside me. I'm pouring them out to the churches that are around in those places. 41 years plus. Engage with the understanding that you are serving the Lord Christ. Amen. Knowing that of the Lord you shall receive the reward of an inheritance, for ye serve the Lord Christ. Colossians 3:24. Let that be behind your mind. You are not serving the church. You are not trying to bring people to a church so the church can be big. No. You are serving the interest of Christ, who wants all men to be saved and to be in church so they can come to the knowledge of the truth in increasing dimensions. Because until they entered the sanctuary of the Lord, then understood I their end. So they need to be in church for their understanding to keep on growing and expanding. Understand you are serving Christ, you're not serving the church. And the good news is, you will need to celebrate your dedication today. Your mockers will be alive to celebrate your dedication today. God is not looking for who to discolor, but who to decorate. You are the lens in line for his decoration. Ye are they which have continued with me in my temptations. I will appoint to you a kingdom as my Father has appointed me, that you may eat and drink with me at my table. Sitting down on thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. Luke 22, verse 28 to 30. God is not looking for who to discolor, but who to decorate. God is not looking for who to humiliate, but who to honor. Your time of honor is here. I just read that to you from John 12 and 26. God is not looking for who to downgrade, but who to upgrade. Which is greater, the one who sits at table to eat or the one who serves? Is it not according to your own concept, the one who sits at the table? But I am in your midst as one that serves. God changes his people's levels through their service. You don't want to remain at the same spot like a statue? Serve God. Serve God. Which one is greater? He said, I'm in your midst as one that serves. So it is service that determines our levels in the sight of God. God is not looking for who to downgrade, but who to upgrade. God is not looking for who to mess up, but who to make. Serving God is not being messed up by God. Is the platform to be made by him. Follow me and I will make you fishers of men. He makes people who are after fishing of men from the waters of woes and calamities. Rescue agents. He makes them. Matthew 4:19. Follow me and I will make you. I will make you. Follow me and I will make you. Is your turn to be made? Is your turn to be made? Any man made by man can be unmade by the devil. But when God makes you, no devil cannot make you. When God makes a man, no devil cannot make him. Now, what God is doing is to bring your life and my life on automatic frequency, where you just live as if the devil were dead. It's all your choice. Praise God. It's all your choice. So wake up and let's believe God to make the most of today, because it is your turn to be decorated. Why are we moving at this pace? We are in the multitude era of the church. What era are we? Multitude era. Yeah, Yes. Not of our church only, the multitude era of the church of Christ. Bless God, we are awake to the reality of it. And we are embarking on what it takes to make it happen. For it shall come to pass in the last days that the mountain of the house of the Lord shall be exalted above all mountains and shall be established above the hills, and all nations shall flow into it. Micah chapter 4, verse 1 and 2. So it is not an inordinate ambition. It is working in the plan, the end time plan and purpose of God for his church. And all people shall flow into it. And many nations shall come and say, come, let's go to the mountain of the Lord and to the house of the God of Jacob, that he may teach us his ways and we'll walk in the path. For out of Zion shall proceed the law and the word of the Lord from Jerusalem. Amen. All the fountains of life shall be domiciled in the church in the end time. Multitudes will be flocking in because the church will become the global solution center. Everybody in need will be heading for church. Everybody under stress will be rushing to church. And that's the era we are in. It shall come to pass in the last days. And what days are we in? Okay, wars and rumors of wars, famines in diverse places, earthquakes in diverse places. We are in the last days, so obvious. Man now marry man and woman marry woman. We're in the last days. There's a lot of corruption in the atmosphere. We're in the last days. Christ will not be long coming. But before he comes, the church will be ready in power. I said the church of Christ will be ready in power. The church of Christ on earth will be ready in power. And so shall it be. Tomorrow, 1st of October, is the D-Day. And as the Lord liveth, the kind of multitude we have never seen, the Bible calls it innumerable multitudes that cannot be numbered, is flocking in here tomorrow. Yeah. That prophet said, this time tomorrow, there shall be surplus supply of food on the streets of Samaria. Tomorrow in our services, we will witness what we have never seen before. Because all the converts of the year, from our video church service platforms, from our outreach platforms, individual platforms of outreaches, so many efforts, and partnership efforts, every one soul that came into the kingdom through our kingdom advancement endeavors shall all appear to abide tomorrow. Every one of them shall appear to abide tomorrow. Shall we rise to our feet, everyone? Lift up your two hands and receive grace for this last moment, this last hours of engagement. Come on now, take that grace from God. 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 The grace to make the most of today. Come on, take it. Receive it. Receive it. I must hit your benchmark of many today. I don't want to just be a participant. I must be a full partaker of the blessedness of this operation in the name of Jesus. Come on, lift up your two hands. Lift up your two hands. Don't play away this moment. They are highly sensitive moment. This last minute will lead to the emergence of stars in our camp. Come on now. Efforts on the telephone, efforts on SMS, efforts on emails, efforts on WhatsApp. What every platform of engagement that will get all of your own converts of the year, all of your own contacts of the year, gather together, gather to abide in church tomorrow. Now pray, pray. That will make them call you today and say, we are coming tomorrow. We are coming tomorrow. I saw your SMS. Thank you very much. I'm coming tomorrow. In Jesus' precious name we are praying. In the name of Jesus we are praying. In the name of Jesus we are praying. Now, tomorrow's service will be a Holy Ghost service. And that means destruction of every yoke. That means confirmment of breakthroughs. Not just marital breakthroughs, there shall be all-round breakthroughs. As there shall be all-round breakthroughs. Everything about everyone's life shall be positively imparted. in the name of Jesus Christ. Tell everyone you are inviting. It's a breakthrough service. It's a Holy Ghost service. Amen. We're beginning our series on the Holy Ghost tomorrow. Hallelujah. Amen. And when it comes down, impossible doors open. So every closed door against anyone's life in any form shall be forcefully opened tomorrow. Yeah. Everything sitting on anyone's destiny shall be unseated tomorrow. Yeah. In the name of Jesus. Yeah. When it came down, the upper room opened up. The upper room opened up. Every place you may have been hiding for fear opens up in your favor tomorrow. Yeah. Whatever won't let you go must come down for you. Yeah. Lift up those two hands to heaven. Now, every of your desire concerning these last moments of this operation, I declare them delivered. Yeah. In the name of Jesus Christ. Yeah. Thank you, Father. And blessed be your name. In Jesus' precious name. In Jesus' precious name. In Jesus' precious name. For all the locations where you have an, sanitation. Today, I'm told they have sanitation in Ogun State. We shut down now for you to go home. We continue till 7:15, just pressing the last buttons and praying together before the full soldiers go on. Jesus is Lord. Amen. Let's have some praise going on. We serve a prayer answering God. We are going to see wonders tomorrow. Now, we are celebrating, we are praising Him, because Thanksgiving is one key to engaging the God of multiplication in action. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
I serve a God who answers prayers. I serve a God who answers prayers. I serve a God who answers prayers. Who answers prayers? Who answers prayers? Forevermore, I serve a God. was answered prayer.